Hello students, today we are again gathering and we are going to discuss about the optical isomerism, which is in a burning topic of the haloalkane and haloarenes. First of all, we have to discuss that what is the optical isomerism. In optical isomerism, this concept we are using in two reactions. That is one SN1 reaction and in the SN2 reaction. In SN1 reaction, we study the retention and in SN2 reaction, we study the inversion of configuration. Inversion of configuration. To understand these concepts and how the optical isomerism is related with this, we have to understand some basics. In that, first we have to understand what is the plane polarized light. What is plane polarized light? Number two is that, what is optical activity or what are the optical active compound or optical activity. Number three, we have to discuss about the enantiomers, and number four, we have to discuss about the distereo isomers. To understand this concept, we must understand first that what is the plane polarized light. Plane polarized light, when we take simple light, when we take the simple light, it goes in all the directions, and when this plane polarized light is crossed through the solution, or whenever it is crossed through the Nicol prism, we will get the light that is unidirectional, that is rotating unidirectionally in one direction, you can say that. Now the term to understand that this is the plane polarized light. If this light falls on an organic compound or any compound, if this light, after falling the organic compound, it moves to clockwise direction, then that compound is called dextrorotatory. Simply we can say that by plus sign. And if this light when falls on the organic compound and goes to the anti-clockwise direction, then they are known as levorotatory. Generally it is represented by minus sign. Now the term is understand. Next is that what is optical active compound. Student, you understand, for optical active, first we require the plane polarized light. When this normal light falls on the Nicol prism, it is made up of the calcium carbonate. Then it convert the plane normal light into the unidirectional light. And then when this light falls on any organic compound, that convert that light into the clockwise direction, we are getting dextrorotatory. And if it goes to anti-clockwise, then we are getting liberatory substance. Now come on the second point, that is optical active compound. And what is optical activity? Now the term is that what is optical activity? Optical activity, or what is optical active compound? The compound which can rotate the path of plane polarized light, which can rotate the path of plane polarized light, are called optical active compound. One point is this, and its example is carbohydrate, and in carbohydrate we can take glucose or fructose, etc. One more thing is there to have the optical activity. Optical active compound are having chiral carbon. Now the chiral carbon is that carbon, whenever any carbon is attached with the four different group, then it stands for asymmetry. C2H5OH, and this goes for Cl. If any compound which is having four different group attached to it, that is called chiral carbon. Chiral carbon stand for asymmetric, and asymmetry is that whenever four different molecules or four different group attached to a carbon, it is the reason for the optical active for the carbon compounds. And one more definition of the optical active compound is that whenever the images are non superimposable, they are also called non-superimposable, they are also called optical active compound, in that it is not necessary carbon must be there, in that carbon is not required, simply they must be mirror image of each other but not superimposable. It's one more simple example is our hand. Now to take an account and understand this one, we are having the chiral carbon. Now two basic terms based on optical activity, that is the